Long time no see,
hey? Long time no see.
I don't think I've actually been on camera for like ever. Like, how long's it actually been? It's been like, well, we recorded on Christmas Day, but you still haven't seen that vlog. So I will be putting that up because I want it just as much for you guys to see, but as much for us to see, because it was Callow's first Christmas, wasn't it? I think I've got foundation on my lips. Not that I meant to have foundation on my lips. So I thought I'd pick up the camera and do a little like catch up vlog. Now, if you don't like listening to me talk, you probably don't watch our vlogs. If you don't mind listening to me babble on about what's been happening, then you can grab a tea and catch up with what's been happening. I haven't got a tea because I've got a little girl instead. Do you want to come say hello? Because you haven't seen everyone in a while. Hey! She's getting big girl, aren't you? So, to start with Callow, obviously. She's 8 months old now. She's just this week learned how to say hiya and dada. So, 8 months old, you started talking. Clever girl! And she can stand, and she started to try and let go with both hands to try and stand on her own, but she obviously can't stand on her own yet, so she just falls. Getting confident though, aren't you? Hey? You're getting a confident little girl. So she's running around, well, crawling around, but fast. She's got this like really fast little crawl on the go. She hasn't been very well, have you? We took her to the doctors yesterday and they said she could have tonsillitis coming. Hopefully not. Hopefully it's just a sore throat. You just woke up, haven't you? So you've got all marks on your face from where you've been sleeping. But yeah, so hopefully it's not tonsillitis. She's been given this nasal spray to help with her breathing. She's so snotty. I always used to hate that when I was like younger and people had kids and they would talk about like snotty children. It'd always make me go, but now I've got my own. It literally doesn't bother me. Well, doesn't bother me with her. It does for other children. Apart from Pippa and Jasmine, because Pippa and Jasmine, I feel like are my own children as well. Is that you? Is that a little girl? Say hiya. You say, you wave and say hiya. She's still primarily on milk, but she has like 3 meals a day. So like porridge in the morning with her milk. And then for lunch, I'm still trying to figure that out. I've been giving her like toast with spreads on and butter and or like malt loaf, something like that. And then for tea, she has like anything. So it'll be like fish fingers some days, won't it? She's tried beans, spaghetti, potato croquettes, garlic bread. She loves garlic bread, but chokes on garlic bread constantly. We had to call 999 literally like a couple of weeks ago because luckily they didn't have to come out or anything. But she would choke. We were talking and then she just started choking and I turned around and looked at the high chair and she was like, blue, going blue. And like Sammy always says, if they're making noise, it's better because they can still get in like air through their airwaves, like still breathing and coughing. But she wasn't. She was like silent. So I panicked. And then it was like for about 2-3 minutes, Josh was smacking her back and nothing was coming up. So I called 999. And luckily, she started coughing just towards the end, just before the like they called one out. And he said, oh no, it's okay. If she's coughing, she should be okay. And they stayed on the phone and everything was fine. So luckily one didn't have to come out, but you're not very good with chewing food, are you still? Especially garlic bread. We'll get there though. She's getting better. Very vocal. She's always talking to us. Still hasn't said mama yet though. But she's always going dad, 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 dad when she's talking, aren't you? Oh, I feel like I love her more than when I last spoke to you. And I know that sounds crazy, but like, I literally love her more and more every single day. Like every single day I love her more and more. It's mad. Been a bit of a whirlwind for me. To be honest, the reason we kind of weren't vlogging, because we did like a we're back video and then we never actually came back, was oh you're right. Did you choke on your own spit there? The reason we kind of didn't vlog after that video was because we've had so many problems with our Adobe Suite. We've only got now one laptop with Adobe Suite when we did have 3 laptops with the Adobe Suite. And we're still trying to figure that out and get that working. But hopefully Josh has got this like,
wait there a minute, let me put Callie down.
Josh has got this like update thing on his MacBook that he's bought, so it should run faster, which means we should be able to get the Adobe Suite back on that. So that means we can edit more. But also, I was really up and down. Now, I wasn't like, when I was down, I wasn't like depressed. It wasn't that bad, but I was just really low because obviously I knew I was going back to work, and it's something I dreaded the day I went off on maternity leave. I dreaded going back. Now, I didn't go back to my old job, but I knew I was gonna have to find a new job and start work again, which meant obviously I was gonna be away from Callow, and every mum knows how the dread literally just consumes every one of your thoughts. Like, since probably the start of November, I cried so much because the thought of going back to work and leaving Callow was just too much, and I just thought, I can't do it. Like, I just feel like I can't do it. Obviously, I knew I had to because we can't afford for me not to work. So I didn't feel like picking up the camera. Like, who wants to be on camera when you feel like shit? You're not in a very positive mood anyway, and you don't want to be just moaning to people on camera. So I decided that I wasn't going to vlog, and that's why we just haven't picked up the camera. And it's sad because I feel like I've missed a lot of... What's she doing?
What are you doing?
I feel like I've missed a lot of... It's sad because I feel like I've lost a lot of memories from not vlogging, because that was one of the best things about doing these videos, was capturing memories. And I feel like I lost so many. I haven't, because they're in here, but I can't watch them because I haven't been vlogging. So it's nice to kind of pick up the camera again and start recording what she's like at this age and how I was feeling at this stage and all of that type of thing. But yeah, so I just didn't really feel like picking up the camera. And thankfully, I found a job pretty quickly. So I started looking for a job, and within like a week I had one. It was the quickest I've ever found and got a job. And it was just luck, really, because my mum, my next door neighbour, Kate, is my mum's friend. So my mum contacted Kate, who works at this place. I don't want to say where I work. I don't know why. Why do I feel funny about saying where I work? It's not... I just feel weird because it's like my life's already all over camera, and I feel like recently I've been having a bit of like a about people knowing everything because of Callow. Like, I don't like people knowing where she goes to nursery. I don't really like people knowing where I go to work, because then they could track me and then follow me and then steal my daughter. I'm not even joking, that is literally what goes through my head like the majority of the time. But at this place, and they were like, oh, there's actually a receptionist job going in the high street at this place. And I was like, oh my God, please put me forward. So she got me in touch with my manager, my now manager, and I got an interview, and then she offered me the job on the spot. So thankfully, praise the Lord, I got a job straight away, perfect hours. I work like Monday to Wednesday, and then every other Saturday. So it's not like... It's three shifts and four shifts and three shifts and four shifts, which is perfect. It means I'm getting like a solid, you know, a solid amount of money a week or a month to like tie us over. It's just a little bit more than what I get on maternity leave. So, you know, it's good. It's a really nice job as well so far. Like, I'm just a receptionist, so it's quite, it's comfortable. The girls seem so nice who I work with anyway. They just all seem really nice people, which is obviously the main thing, because I always think it's the people who make a job, not necessarily what you're doing. I just really like it, and I feel like I could stay there for a while I have all my babies, because when I had Callow, I said I only wanted Callow because I never wanted to do labour again. I'm kind of over the labour now, and now I want like 50 children. I'm like, Josh, should we have another one? Come on, let's have another one. You won't let us yet though. And to be fair, I want to wait till Callow's a little bit older, because I want to enjoy her on her own for a little bit. And also, I see how Sammy and Jeebus deal with having two children that close together, and it's hard work, and I don't want two children that close together. I'm alright having my children that aren't actually mine. I feel like Jasmine and Pippa are like my children that I get to cuddle and kiss and hug and play with, but then I can give back. So it's like having grandchildren, I suppose, but I'm like Auntie Beth, not Grandma Beth. But yeah, so I've started work. I'm definitely gonna do a video that's gonna be like coping with going back to work and after maternity leave, because whoa, that's a lot. It's a massive, massive lifestyle change, and I would really like to do a video on that. I will do one, I promise. I know I say this all the time and then I don't, but I will do one because I really want to, because I think it could help a lot of people. Like when I did my miscarriage video, that helped so many people. I got so many messages on how much that video helped people, so I want a video like that again. And I'll also want to do a video about preparing for your child to go to nursery, because obviously, as I say, Callow started nursery, which has been a massive hurdle for me to get over, and also her as well. It's been a massive lifestyle change for her. She got ill the first week, because obviously kids pick up so much shit from nursery, and it's just a massive change. She thankfully loved it this week, so that's a good sign. But I'll do a video on kind of that and dealing with and coping with putting them in a nursery, and how you can do certain things to make you feel better about the situation. But yeah, she seems to be really enjoying it at the minute. The first one, I think she was a bit overwhelmed. They said she played with a few things but cried a lot. The second day, which was my second day at work, which sucked, because obviously I was a bit embarrassed, because I was like, I've got to leave because my daughter's screaming at nursery. Thankfully, I only had to leave work for like 45 minutes, I think. Oh, she's trying to grab the camera. And then I went back, but she had to leave nursery because she just wouldn't settle. They said she was just screaming and crying and they couldn't get her to settle. So I had to pick you up, didn't I? And then her third session, which was this week, apparently she loved. She went in, apparently she was playing really nicely, had a proper nap, proper sleep, because that's what makes her grumpy. She ate food, apparently she was really, really good. So I'm hoping that's kind of like the turning point now, and she's going to be all right and she's getting used to it. I suppose it's a lot for her to get used to as well, really, you know, going into a place with strangers and just being left. She only goes once a week, which is nice, so it's not too much. And then one day she's with my stepmom and another day she's with my mum. And that covers obviously my 3 days a week, and then on Saturdays Josh is at home. So if I am at work on a Saturday, it's only for, I only go to work on Saturdays for 5 hours every other week, so it's not a lot at all. But then Josh is here, so I don't need to worry about childcare. But yeah, that's kind of the routine we've got at the moment, which seems to be going really well, so I'm happy with that. It's just been a big lifestyle change, and there's been a lot to get my head around, but I'm feeling really good right now. I feel more motivated, I feel like I want to pick up the camera, I want to start creating artwork again, and I just feel really motivated to get out. I do think that maternity leave is great, like you get to spend all this time with your child and not go to work, which is obviously a massive bonus, but I don't think it's very good for your mental health. And I say that because I think you're stuck in the house with your child, which at the time you think's great because you just get 24/7 with them, but you're stuck in the house with your child, getting no kind of time apart to, they always say, don't they, like, is it something to make the heart grow stronger? Travel, no, time, space, something like that, isn't it? Is it space makes the heart grow fonder? Something like that. But yeah, like time apart definitely makes me appreciate her more when I'm with her. And I just feel better for it. I get like adult conversation, I get to chill out and have a hot cup of coffee, which is so nice. A hot cup of coffee where I haven't got a child like crawling on me and trying to smack me and like pull at my lips and my eyes and get my attention. And I enjoy the people I work with as well, so it's kind of been a bit of a refresh for me, and I feel good for it, even though I thought I was going to feel the most awful I've ever felt. I was like, this is going to be the worst, I'm going to hate it, I don't want to go back to work, but I've actually really enjoyed it. My hair's different too. This is the first time I've worn it in like a side parting. I'm not too sure on it. I've been wearing it like smack bang in the middle like Kim K, but yeah, I've been growing my hair out, and then I cut it shorter because it got to about maybe here and it was too long. I didn't really like it, I didn't think it suited me actually, so I've cut it to like a long bob and then grow my fringe out. It's getting long, my fringe now, like it's like, just gonna pull this camera up, but look, it's like here, so it's getting there. I want it to obviously be in line with everything else. I'd like to go like pastely pink, but it's just the upkeep of it, isn't it? Don't know if I could be bothered for the upkeep of pastel pink. Josh is doing really well. He would be here, but he's upstairs getting ready because we're going out. But he's doing really, really well. His work's got really busy recently. He's had a lot going on at work. He's a graphic designer, so his work comes in like loops. No, I don't know. Like, it gets busy and then it goes quiet, and then it gets busy and it goes quiet. And at the minute, he's got like 4 events coming up, so it's really busy at work. But he's really enjoying it. He prefers it when it's busy. He prefers it when it's like really busy. My artwork as well, because I went over that, but I haven't told you about it. It went up in the lounge. I think I was still vlogging at that point. But my artwork went up in the lounge. Wait. Hiya! Hiya! Mwah! But my artwork went up in the lounge, which was amazing. I'm so appreciative for it. Look at these little teethies. I didn't tell you she's got toothy pegs. She's got 2 little toothy pegs coming through. They came through a couple of weeks ago. So maybe start at 7 months they started coming through. But she's got 2 little toothy pegs down here. Da, 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 da. Mwah. But yeah, my artwork went up in the lounge. It meant that, you know, I was getting more exposure, and thankfully I've sold 2 of them that have been up in the lounge as well, which has been great. And then my artwork this week has gone up in the artisan in Eccleshall, which has been really good. It's got like a, I've got like a whole room. So like it's like got 3 spaces in the artisan, and one of the rooms is just my artwork. So I've got loads of, I think I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 or 10 pieces up in there at the minute. So that's really nice. We're hopefully doing an event there. So that's doing well. I haven't sold a lot. I've sold a few the past month, 2 months, maybe 2 in the past 2 months. So it's not, they don't sell like really fast or anything like that, but I enjoy doing them, so that's all that matters at the end of the day, isn't it? And if they sell, it's great, because, you know, it helps me fund my life and buy nice things. Oh, hey, come and say hey. I'm not doing a vlog, I was just doing like a quick video catch up.
Hey
there. Hey,
do you want me to grab clothes for her?
Yeah, in a minute.
Leave her in pajamas?
No, because if we have some lunch out, then we shall need clothes.
Oh, we're having lunch out.
Well, I don't know, but if normally we go out and we say we won't have it, and then we do have it. But yeah, so that was just like a brief catch up of everything that's been going on. I'm not going to do what I normally do and say I'm definitely going to get a video up on Tuesday, because I probably won't get a video up on Tuesday. So I'm, as I said in the one of my many vlogs that I've said this, they're just going to go up as and when. And hopefully that becomes more regular as I get more time. Right, well, we're gonna go now. So say bye, Calo. Say bye. You say bye. Wave. Bye. Look at her face.